like I said last week, today we're going to look at another one of my favorite commandments, the fourth commandment. Honor your father and your mother. Before that, though, let's remember our baptism with the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, the sign of the cross. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will declare your praise. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Well, there's our Moses picture. He's given the Ten Commandments. And today we look at the fourth commandment, and so let's read it together first, and then we'll listen to it. We'll see if we can sing along to it. Honor your father and your mother. What does this mean? We should fear and love God so that we do not despise or anger our parents and other authorities, but honor them, serve and obey them, love and cherish.
Well,
Joseph didn't become Pharaoh, but he was really close. close to Pharaoh and work with Pharaoh. And what was Joseph in charge of? He was in charge of all the grain in Egypt, and they knew that there was going to be a famine for 7 years, so they had 7 good years before the 7 years of famine. So Joseph coordinated all the storing up of the wheat, and then that way the Egyptians would be able to survive during the famine. But what Joseph does to honor his parents and his family is that he invites them also to come to Egypt to dwell there, so that they could have their good pasture land for their flocks, and so that they could be well nourished. So the way that Joseph shows honor for his parents is by taking care of them when they're old, and also taking care of his siblings. So this is an important part of the Christian life, that we are to care for our parents as they get older, and then also are to look out for the best interests of our siblings, right? Sometimes that's a little hard to do, isn't it? Alright, now, here's the problem. All of us have dishonored our parents before. We haven't always loved and served and cherished and obeyed them, so we're sinners. So, what we need, though, is not just a good example like Joseph, but we need a Savior from sin, and that is Jesus. So, Jesus does two things to save us. One is he actively fulfills the law for us, and that's what we see in this verse. Jesus went down with Mary and Joseph and came to Nazareth and was submissive to them. That means that he respected their authority and obeyed them. And his mother treasured up all these things in her heart. And Jesus increased in wisdom and in stature and in favor with God and man. So Jesus obeyed the fourth commandment and all the commandments perfectly to fulfill God's law for us. And then the second thing he did to save us was he suffered and died for all of our sins. So in John 17, Jesus shows that he came to glorify and honor his Father in heaven, who sent his Son, because he loved the world so much, he sent his Son to be our Redeemer. So John 17 is the chapter of the Bible right before Jesus goes up to suffer and die. That's recorded in John 18 and 19. And after Jesus had said a lot of words to his disciples on the night when he was betrayed, he said, when Jesus had spoken these words, he lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all flesh to give eternal life to all whom you have given him. And this is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth, having accomplished the work that you gave me to do. And now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with the glory that I had with you before the world existed. Here, Jesus is showing us that he's not only a man, but he's also true God. He is God the Son, who was with the Father before the world even existed. He was the Son of God, the Word of God, and the Word was made flesh to dwell among us. And then he glorified God the Father by giving up his life on the cross to win eternal life for us. And today he says, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. And then he asks, do you believe this? And we say, yes Lord, we believe. So Jesus obeys his mother and his guardian, Joseph, perfectly. While he was growing up. And then he honors his father by laying down his life for us on the cross, so that we who have broken the fourth commandment have forgiveness. And now he also gives us the Holy Spirit to help us obey the commandments, so that we can, in our daily Christian walk, learn to keep the commandments more and more. Let us pray. Lord God, our Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you for giving us our parents and other authorities as your representatives here on earth to care for and serve us. We pray that you would forgive us for the times that we have disobeyed them or dishonored them, and grant us forgiveness for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ. Help us by the power of your Spirit each day to honor and care for our families and to love and serve you with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, let's say Luther's morning prayer and then